Welcome to the Resilient Diabetic. In today's episode, we will discuss alternative blood testing sites to our traditional go-to spot. Yeah, our delicate little fingers. If you're new, my name is Jay Sampat, and this is where we turn ordinary struggling diabetics into extraordinary well-controlled diabetics. If that's your goal, you're going to want to hit that subscribe button. I will not only give you great alternative sites that are just as accurate to the fingers, minus the pain, but at the very end, so stay tuned for that, several tips to ensure the least amount of pain and the most consistency of readings possible. This episode goes into conjunction with a prior episode that I did called Glucose Meter Basics for Diabetics. That video covers a lot of the mistakes diabetics make when it comes to obtaining the accurate readings and the issues associated with those glucose meters in particular. I will set up a link in the description box below, and at the very end of the video, you will see a kind of a white box floating around. Click that. That will take you directly to that episode. If you're anything like me, and where I test my blood sugars usually 4 to 7 times a day, then over time, you'll start developing some issues in and around those fingers. For one, the fingers over time will become chronically sore. For those such as myself, when my hands are cold, you're kind of unable to draw blood. Those fingertip areas are laden with pain nerves, causing the Lancet process to be probably the most sensitive and the most uncomfortable for us as diabetics. And over time, that could leave fingertips bruised, calloused, and at the very end, lead to what's known as reduced tactile sensation, meaning fingertips become less sensitive. So what does that leave us? Well, looking for alternative sites that help improve our life. And what do those include? The palm, the forearm, the upper arm, the thigh, the calf, and some even use the knee. This is really important caveat. Before you go testing alternative sites, you need to discuss all this with your doctor and care team first. Read the instructions on the blood glucose meter you have and make sure that sites that are identified on the instructions are used for that specific meter. Because not all glucose meters are designed to support alternative testing other than the fingers. So beware. Because the skin of the alternative sites contain fewer nerves than the fingertips, they may be more comfortable for a lot of people. But what are the downfalls to that? Blood sugar results could vary depending on where you test and when you test. Say you get a blood sample from your thigh. And your blood sugars are going up significantly at the time, you may get what's known as a delayed result. In other words, the results you're seeing from your thigh were what your blood sugars were 20 to 30 minutes ago. They may not be accurate for what's known as the present moment. And that can be critical for those who are using insulin, such as myself. Second problem you may face is actually getting enough blood for that sample. I can't get blood from my forearms regardless of how I've tried. If it works, and you've tested and it's accurate to your fingertips, it's another great site for you to use. Gentil, they are the makers of a specific Lancet device, did a test where they measured the rate of change of glucose between the knee and the calf, which is an alternative site, the fingertips, and the palm, which is great. Now, I'll put up some charts for you, and I'll link their internet site down below for you to get a chance to see more of their charts. And what did it show? First and foremost, their tests do show that the alternative sites like the calf and the knee not only lag, and actually they're very accurate with this, lag behind by about 22 minutes. But here's the second problem that most have not figured out yet, or they will figure out in time. It only reads about 70% of the rise of the peak values the fingertips did produce. So one has to be very careful when using alternative sites, especially, again, those of us who are using insulin. You're not only seeing a delayed result, but lower peak levels than what is accurate. It also shows the area of the palm as an excellent secondary site now on part of the fingers, and that's great. Why? One, it's capillary blood, so it's going to reflect current blood sugar levels. The question is, where on the palms do they test? The fleshy parts. This part's right here, and the parts right here. I've used them, and it works just as well. However, Gentil also found that testing on the palm with the regular Lancet supplies didn't always provide easy way to get enough blood for the test strips. So you may have to go a little deeper depth on your Lancet device to get enough blood. You'll have to test and see what works best for you. Some of the very, very important keynotes. Alternative sites should only be used when your blood sugars are stable. Really important to understand. And when would that be? Immediately before bed, immediately before a meal, or when fasting. However, checking your fingertip is critical when blood glucose levels are changing and changing rapidly. When would that be? Following a meal? After exercise? And I've learned that a million times. I check my blood sugars at my fingertips after I exercise every time. Also too, when you think your blood sugars may be low or falling quickly too. What are the 7 tips I'll provide for you? You can test on the side of your fingers. Try not to use the flat, fleshy part that most of us I've come very accustomed to using. It's probably gonna be the most painful. So when testing, use the side of your fingers because not only is it less painful, but there's better blood flow. Warm your hands up. Not only can cold hands be more painful, but they're actually harder to draw blood. What I do is I will always normally start off by washing my hands. And when I do and they're cold, I will use as hot as water as I could tolerate. That brings my hands up to a nice temperature and brings the blood back to the surface, and it's less painful for me. Now, what if you don't have access to water? You can just sit on your hands or rub them together really hard and fast. That should get some blood flow going back to the tip of your fingers. Second thing, you want to adjust your Lancet depth. If getting blood is always painful, maybe your Lancet is set to a little too hard or a little too deep. Part of managing diabetes includes adjusting the depth and the force of that Lancet properly. Now, on my Lancet device, I use a setting of around 2 or 3. Anything more than that, it hurts. This may be a new one for a lot of diabetics. And in my video, The Glucose Meter Basics for Diabetics, I mentioned I always try and wash my hands first. And if I don't have access to that, I will go to the alcohol wipes. But remember, folks, alcohol is an astringent, which basically tightens the skin and makes obtaining blood samples a little more difficult. So using those wipes could add to the variability of both pain and discomfort. So it's something to think about first, and that's usually why I wash my hands over using the alcohol pads. Switching fingers regularly. Try not get into the habit of using the same finger, the same spot, over and over again. That would lead to calluses and scarring. Now what I do is I will rotate all my fingers. I'll go left to right, right to left, and then use different parts of each fingers over time. And I've learned that's usually the best method for myself. Fresh Lancets are always sharper, so the more you use them, the duller they get, the more it's going to add to pain. The Lancet and the monitoring system. Different blood glucose monitors require different depths of the Lancet. If the current one is too painful, go back to your doctor and ask him for a different Lancet and device. Right after I was first diagnosed as a diabetic, after leaving the emergency care, I ended up going to the nearest pharmacy where I picked up my first glucose meter and Lancet device. And I ended up getting the cheapest one I could find until I saw my doctor. And I remember to this day, the first time I took my reading, it was a very painful Lancet device. I couldn't believe that I was going to go through this for the rest of my life with how painful that was. But when I got a chance to see my doctor, they prescribed me a different brand, a different Lancet, and it was night and day. So if the one you have right now is not working, I suggest you go see your doctor. If you found this episode helpful, please hit those alerts for me. Look for that gray bell on the top of your screen. That'll notify you when new episodes are released. That subscribe button, and if you like what you heard today, that like button. It's super important for us new channels. The more you hit those alerts, the more you subscribe, the more YouTube's computer, their little algorithm, promotes this channel. Thus, the more people get to see it. That's why I always continually ask. I need you to please share this with other diabetics who strive for a better life. And in the comment section below, I would love to know how often per day you test your blood sugars. List the spots you prefer, and do you use a specialized Lancet device? If so, how does it work? How does it compare to the other ones you've used? This information can really help all the new diabetics that are coming in every single week. So have a great day, a productive week, and we will see you soon with an episode released every week. Bye.